The following is a look at one of the hundreds of videos our members get at cjkdmember.com. This particular one is an example of a private training session with Ninja, using principles of Wing Chun for effective street fight defense, regardless the type of attacker. If I'm standing like this, it's going to be or it'll be here, or it'll be, uppercut. But I'm carrying it. I can carry it this way, I can carry it that way. If I go here, I work to cut off that line, because I want to punch you, right? So I'm going to do the best thing possible to punch you, which means get closer to that face and center line so I can do that. I cut the line. If I go out here, any movement you make is a huge error of deflection. So I want to minimize that by getting closer to you and sinking that shot. My hip coming in, landing on that, sends that to you. So this motion is all part of here. It's the simultaneous movement. So if you were to throw a punch at me, touch, just hit me. Okay, this is what I'm doing. I'm looking at passing, letting that force go out. Do it again, see? Now I'm changing the path by allowing it to go through or opening it out to here. If I open it out, I change that path. Center line, there we go, center line. Working here, right? So break it down to that. First, get out of the way of the strike. One way or the other. Just body movement. Just body movement. Hand down. There you go. That way or the other way. You decide. I'm going to center each time. Okay. Punctuate your step now each time. Punctuate your step. Now punctuate your step closer to me. Because I'll move. I'm just going where your center was before you moved, right? So that's all you're doing. You're cutting that zigzag corner to me every time. Now you're going to incorporate. We're going to go just to the outside. Incorporate that. Stick it. Hip has to drive into it. Ball of the foot has to land hard. Do so. Yeah, step, movement, step, movement. Put that down first. Yes, that's it. Punch, no, just punch. Don't even worry about moving it. Clear that space. Step. Okay, relax. Good. No hand. Get the hand up. I'm just doing movement right now. So eager to hit me, are you? I'm just going to hit your chest. You felt that before.
Just make me less flinchy.
Yep. Sure does. You're hitting this on target. You're working well.
I'll still close my eyes.
As long as you carry the punch into it accurately. Make it and then throw an overhand. Yes, immediately after. Correct. Mm-hmm. On my mark.
Mm.
Yeah. If you think about the next thing, you may not be getting caught in, because right now you're concerned with your own what you see as a failing or a stopping point or whatever else, and you stop there every time. So we're going to get you past that point by making you strike there and then strike the next one. Okay. So you get two hits in, that helps ensure your survival, versus one hit, I'm stopping and realizing I messed up. Okay. Realize you messed up after you've already done two good solid hits.
Ha ha ha.
all of them have to have that sinking, sink, sink. Punctuate, punctuate. There you go, punctuate. Punctuate. That's it. Punctuate. Bam, 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 bam. Yeah. Bam. Sink it. Punctuate. Punctuate. Yes. Yes. Nice. That's it. Now you're just going to do that off my punch. Piece of cake. Everything is in play. Yeah. Focus on the hits. Yes. That's it. Punctuate each one. Bam, bam. That's it. One, two. Bass has to be there punctuating before
you
fire.
That's the problem.
Yep, exactly. Break them up. Two different shots. Come on, two different shots. Boom, boom, again. Boom, boom. Two, one, two. One, two. Sink, sink. Each one. Punctuate each one. Punctuate each one. Punctuate, punctuate. Punctuate, punctuate. Now I'm going to hit. That's it. That's it. That's it. But it's there. You got the speed. The only thing that's throwing that off is just my interaction with you is all.
Trying to get out of the way of the punch.
You're there. If you throw a jab like you were just doing it, you're already out of the way of the punch. If you punctuate your footstep on the jab, you punctuate it on a slightly moved position than you were before. My punch is going where you are. If you move slightly, remember how we did that with you're just rotating? Rotate the punch, there you go. I'm going to center regardless, okay? So that's my goal, bam. I'm hitting there. You're already moving appropriately. All you do is you take a little bit of step to punctuate the footwork. It already moves you off just the hair, and that's all you need when you're rotating into the strike properly. It's taking care of itself. It's built into the mechanics. And just like on the Rebel Wing Chun Battle Blast, the hips are ahead of the next shot already.
Yeah.
I have fired here, they're already going on to the next one. So for me to fire this one, the hips are already back and firing for the next one before this one is even completed. As this one is working to complete its shot, this one is already tripped and fired, and by that time you're going on to the next one even. That's what speed does. Speed makes that hip movement trip from one to the next faster. Trip the hips faster. There you go. That's how we do a class. So if I'm working, this is for members, so if I'm working to ingrain some mechanics, I have to break it down into those components. That first step is, I am going to hit her. I actually am going to make contact to her chest. All she's going to do is rotate out to the side. In this particular case, because of my foot positioning and her matching my lead, I'm going to have her just turn so that when she extends her jab, it's in the proper place. So that means every time that I send this out, she's just going to rotate the shoulders so that she doesn't even have to throw a punch. This is just about the matrix move. And again, we break that up in our timing so it's not repetitive. We get used to that for a bit, then we break it up. Then it's in here. I am going to hit this if she doesn't move. I'm not going to hit it full power, but I am going down center line. I am going to extend it in. It'll be more of a loose fist when I make the landing if she doesn't move properly. But I am going to do it. She will move if I land. And you can see a side angle on that, so you can see how far I'm actually traveling on that punch, because that's important. Because I'm not stopping here. I am actually going here. Now, first starting out, that's terrifying to a lot of beginners. Go with a palm strike. I'm just gonna palm strike to center, palm strike, but with that same penetration. Later, as you have control and as they get more comfortable with it, because you got to get rid of the fear part first, and that means you build it in progression with the palm strikes. Finger touch first, just finger touch. But finger touch with penetration. I'm not touching here, I'm touching to actually touch and push her. Then you go to palm strike. Then you go to fist. You don't have to go to fist. You can put a wear glove, that'll make it easier. Grappling glove, that's a good progression to build. So now she's getting used to that read, and then she's getting used to the tripping, okay? Which is important because she's got to know when to do that. Then we just add this. She's just going to punch on that line. All I'm going to do is go here, and she's just going to punch. That's it. So you can do it two different ways. One, she's completely relaxed. The hand is down. She's caught in a surprise position. She's got to fire the shot into me. Now, from that, what I saw is I just need to have her do more rotation into the strike so that it turns her upper torso more. That will force her to put more, what I call punctuating the step. You step down a little harder on the ball of the foot as you rotate. There we go. The impact on the pad is much different, and her angle is better. Then the other way to do it is from the hands up position, where she's in a ready position and ready to go. So now she's from here, there should be no hesitation. Once the strike comes in, it should come in faster because it doesn't have to go from the ground up. Everything I'm doing is the same that I was doing earlier. And that's it, so that's good. Anything that you'll look for is that rotation. You got to make sure that as I'm coming through here, this line is good, because that means this line into the target is going to be good. Good penetration, that's what we want. Depth on the strike, that's what I mean by penetration. So your mechanics will carry that. We're doing an elbow down position. Those are harder to defend, they're faster to target. It also deflects. If I get on the low line, she can bring the elbow into play to stop my shoot, that sort of thing, in case I parry that or whatever else. She can go right down to blocking that. So it's built into the mechanics. I do this to cover all angles as much as possible, including knife attacks. Then all we're going to do is punctuate. Now we're going to first get used to striking here and then striking with the overhand. So if the overhand mechanics aren't in there, these are the overhand mechanics. I'm going to hold it at an angle. This is important for her because it sets up the punch properly so that she doesn't damage her hand on the hit. She's going to raise her elbow up higher and sink it down in that manner. Now you can rotate it to a three-quarter position if you want, or you can just go directly from your how the arm feels most relaxed going into it. So it's a pistoning effect that goes out like this, right into the target. So bam, you get her used to doing that. Now you tie that in with the hip movement. So the hip snaps, bam. Yeah, the faster the hip snaps, the more I've got to use two hands for the impact, because it's actually pretty hard. And it's all relaxed, see? There we go. The things you look for on that strike is people will sometimes bring this elbow down because it's more muscle involvement. It's lazy. It's our bodies try to go to the most conservative position possible. We've got to overcome that and go down to proper mechanics possible, which makes it the most efficient strike. There's a difference. This one that comes across like this, that's a low, is easier to deflect. It's easier to interfere with. I can intercept this easier than something that comes up here, because it's unexpected. It's not a normal punch that people do. So for me to sit there and work my standard stuff on that means I'm going to get clocked pretty well, because it's coming at a higher angle of incidence to the target with some oomph. And then we just combine them. Jab. Go high. That's it. And they have to be thought of as two separate strikes that you set before each time. And bam, there you go. One, two. Get the sense for that. nice and relaxed mechanics, good power, that's it, tap and break it down to relax, there you go, sink it, yeah. Now, I'm going to do the same thing I did before, I'm going to just go punching towards her, she's going to do the same thing that she did on this. Now, when we're going for speed, I'm going to go expect the punches to be slower, so this is progression, so I'm going to go here, two, set it into place, here, two, that way it starts getting her used to these things combined. Yeah, don't stop, so even if you think you're off, just keep your mechanics in row, and then I break it up a little bit. I don't care about the combination yet. It's just one, two separate strikes. So that's how you break it. There you go. One, two. One. Okay. Now, for the flow and for speed, she has to snap the hip ahead of each strike. So that means that when she fires the jab, the hip snap first. Hip snap first. There you go. Snap. And then you're going to snap in the other direction before that punch is all the way out even. That triggers the next punch. So jab, snap, snap. So snap ahead of the strike. The faster you trip the hip, the faster you're already set up there. That's the key to get the actual hips, to get the strikes working in combination, in flow, with high speed, with good structure underneath you. You've been doing this a while, so fatigue is a part of this, conditioning is part of this. If the mechanics get too sloppy, you break it down, relax, go back it. If you need to get a drink, if you need to do something else, get back to it, go fresh. But go with the most precise mechanics you can, because your body will find its own level after time. To the length of your limbs, the tendons, connection to muscle, how your body is structured on the inside. That will help form the proper level, basically, your most ease. But you gotta do it from proper mechanics first. So if that's part of the process, of breaking, relaxing, getting back into it, and doing it again. This is uncharacteristic. This is one person. This is a private training type example. But this helps them get into these structures. We have to make it live. That's why this striking comes into play. And then that's why breaking up the timing on that striking is important. And then her getting past her sticking points. Sticking point maybe, I'm just going to fire and then I get stuck after that. It's like, don't worry about the getting stuck. If you flub up on the first one, fire the second one anyway. And then we'll deal with the combination. It's not fire and then stop and think that, oh, I messed up, and then do it again, because that ingrains the habit of stopping when you have felt you did something wrong. Your survival means the end result. Everything that's coming in play here, when she fires here to here, if it flubs up, if it's interrupted because I'm doing something else, she continues the attack, regardless of whether she messed up. Her body will adapt, her mechanics will come into play to support continuing the strike. Gotta get used to getting past the breaking point, which is her own thought, I messed up and I'm gonna stop for a second and then get to start over. No starting over, do the flow. If we need to start over, we break it back down to first principle. We go back to first example. Hip movement on the strike, yep, then add the strike, then we go to the second strike separately, just that, and then trip that, then we combine them both, then bam, bam, get that punctuated step, and then I add my input to it, bam, bam, my input, don't stop at that point, fire regardless, that's it, and then I break up that timing. Fatigue sometimes is a real big thing. We're in Florida humidity. We've been doing this for quite a while. The sweat on her body isn't because somebody poured water on her. We did hill work earlier, so that was part of our conditioning. Carrying people on the shoulders up the hill and up the stairs. doing a lot of the conditioning. That was all part of the stuff we did before doing this. So this is just so you get an idea of how we do this training. Sometimes we'll start this type of training first and then go and build the conditioning exercises at the end, which really builds up, it breaks up the monotony of how the body thinks it's going to start conditioning. You surprise it and you shock it. Sometimes you train a little bit of this, then go into conditioning drills, then go back into more of the technique. So here we're doing it the other way around, conditioning first, heavy exhaust us, then going into this. Now, because we did a lot of the leg work, we're actually going to do more leg work for the technique. So we're blasting legs today, which you can do. Sometimes you blast alternating ones. Sometimes if I blast the legs in the morning, then the techniques are heavy on the high line. But today, we blasted the legs in conditioning. We're now going to go back to blasting the legs for our technique.